All right, welcome back to the Good Morning Naija show. And yes, for those who are not there with me from the beginning, I appreciate you. And I go hope so you're there with me to the end because a lot of things still there in store for on our top of the show this morning. So not go anywhere there with me. Now, we're moving into our next conversation. We talk, say, because we know if we bring our guests come inside studio due to a COVID-19 situation for the country, would they get our conversations via Skype? And today, be Monday, and as it be, we'd like to motivate ourselves to know the right things, to know what to do, to find our purpose. And no other person to talk to us about this matter than Jimmy Tewe, and a public speaker. And we would like to get some kind of very, very necessary conversations regarding that. Welcome to the Good Morning Naija show, Jimmy. And thank you for joining us
this
morning.
Thank you. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. I'm doing really, really good. All right. So it's a tradition that I always get to ask my guests how they are doing, honestly. We know that there's a pandemic. A lot of things have changed. Unexpected things have happened. So we'd like to ask you, how are you doing, honestly? Let's be sincere.
I'm actually very well, because even though I didn't know about the pandemic, obviously most of us know about it, but I had begun to move my business online already. And so what it just did was that I had to accelerate what I was doing. So I have been busiest the last 3-4 months.
Okay.
So it's been good.
I'll put it that way. Yeah. That's really good to hear. So it's like you had like a foresight of what to expect, and you went ahead. That's interesting.
Sure.
That's interesting. So let's even talk about, so today's conversations, we're going to be touching, you know, two very major areas that have to do with the human life as it is, and its purpose. We know that a lot of times it's not easy to actually find that purpose that you are, as an individual, finding your purpose is quite difficult. And people dabble into things here and there, looking for something that works. If it doesn't work, they dabble into another one. So that's, as somebody who's an expert in understanding these kind of processes, how or what would you say are the major things or ways you can use to find your purpose? Just in a nutshell, let's see how far we can go about this.
All right. Thank you very much. With regards to that, there are two basic theories that drive understanding in that area. So you have the evolutionist, you have the creationist. What that means essentially is that you either believe that we evolved, and that means that if you evolved, you basically have to find your way in this world until you end your time in this world. The other angle, which is the creationist, is basically that you are a product of creation and that there's an intent or purpose to your life. Mm-hmm. And so one of them says that you have a predetermined end, as it were, or that there are certain things that have been set already. Mm-hmm. The other one says you basically have to find a way, you're going to be successful, you know, do certain principles, and eventually are going to get there.
Yeah.
So you have to pick one of those options in life, all right? So I'm more from the patient side. But I think that sometimes, you know, some people have stretched it to the point that it is now so confusing. You know, because they say, oh, find what it is you are angry about. Mm-hmm. Say, find what it is you love doing if you're not going to be paid and all that. And while there's some elements of truth around this kind of thing, I believe that, you know, the concept of purpose is essentially driven by different areas. First is design. Mm-hmm. So if I pick up anything, I pick up my phone, for example, my phone is designed according to purpose. And so what that means essentially is that your design, when I talk about your design, I'm not speaking about your external frame, that could contribute to it, is a lot about the things that have to do with what is on the inside of you. So that would involve things around your personality, things around your tendencies, things around your cognitive abilities. These are some indicators. So everything is designed according to purpose. And so if you believe in the creationist and all that, which I do, you believe that God created you and designed you to succeed. So, in fact, the design of a thing is designed such that it's meant to enable you to succeed. So design is an enablement for purpose. And so the way that you think, your interest. So, for example, I tell people that everybody is not interested in everything. For example, I'm not interested in going to space. So I'm never going to go and study anything that has to do with, you know, traveling out of space or deep physics or things like that.
Yeah.
In fact, in secondary school, you know that in GSS3, you know, we had this exam that we normally do. That is actually the first place where, based on design, people should be directed. So I, for example, I was a science student. Well, not like Olamide says, but I was a science student. Part to, you know, by areas of interest. Some people are more inclined towards art, but you know that most people that are in science got there because they scored the highest scores. It doesn't necessarily mean that that's what they are, you know, that's their inclination. So you find out that many times later, they decide, I don't want to do this any longer because they say this, that is not me. In other words, inherent on the inside of us, our design, our tendencies, they are indicators of where exactly we should be headed in that direction. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm a career coach, and I'll tell you something, that the work you do is meant to enable you be you. In other words, you fit like a square peg in a square hole.
Yeah.
Do you get my point?
Yeah.
Because that, so I, for example, I headed recruitment for, two Nigerian banks at different times, United Bank for Africa, and also Bank PHB. And I remember that while I do the job at that point in time, I realized that my strongest moment was when I was doing things like career counseling, things like career advice and all that, and people would come and gravitate towards me. So when I left the banking sector in 2010, I moved into career counseling and career coaching, and I've pretty much done that for most of my time outside. And when I do it, I do not stress to do it, all right? I've built myself in the area of knowledge. Now, people say to me, Jimmy, I don't like reading. And I say to people, no, everybody would like to read and find what they are interested in. Everybody reads, but the question is about interest. So once your interest is not aligned with what you have to do, you have to force you to do it.
Yeah.
And that's the thing that I remember the first course that I ever was interested in reading. I studied agricultural economics, University of Ibadan. Amazing course, but I did not enjoy it because that wasn't me. But there was a course on management. That was the first book that I read after the class throughout my university years. Every other one was before exam. Why? Because I was interested in it. And so what we find out is that the people that do enjoy life now, I mean, a lot of people work because they want to make money. Making money, all right, you can actually be doing what you're interested in it and still not make money.
True.
Because there is another economics attached to that. So I find people that say, oh, but I'm doing what I love to do and I'm not making money. No. Making money has its own principles and rules that are attached to it.
Yeah.
So yes, you can do. I love what I do every single day. Once we are through with this, this week I have about 50 coaching sessions that I have to run through with people, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And they're about an hour and all that. I am looking forward to it because they are giving me the opportunity to be able to be me, and they are paying me for it.
Hmm.
You understand my point?
Yeah, totally.
So that's what I mean. There are different products we can use to purpose, but I've been speaking for a bit, and I hope that what I've said, you know, has helped a bit.
Totally. It even opened up points for a little bit, for more questions. You said something about you can be doing what you love, but you might not be getting money for that. You might not be getting money as expected. And that alone has really made a lot of people confused. Because sometimes they say, oh, do what you love. You will excel at it because you're going to be doing it at your best. So people will opt out of a proper job or a proper employment that they have to do what they love.
Yes.
And in the end, they get in there and it's not the grass is not as green and at the other side as they expected. So it takes them back like five steps back to think that, oh, maybe all this while that I think I love to paint. I love painting.
Yes.
Maybe now that I'm painting, maybe I never was supposed to paint in the first place. Well, if this is my passion, I love to do this, I can do this without being paid. But in a case where this happens, what advice would you give to somebody who is confused at a point like that? Should he run back to his regular job, or what's the way out?
All right, thank you. I mean, again, I was in that exact place, you know, a couple of years ago. So when I left the banking sector, I was a senior manager in the banking industry. I was earning a lot of money. Well, technically at that level, I had a mortgage, I bought a house, I had to sell the house, return the money to the bank because I wanted to pursue my passion.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, they say, oh, change your dream. My dream became a nightmare, literally speaking, you know, and I got to points where, well, I didn't want to go back, but I was like, am I sure about going forward? And eventually I learned, it took me a number of years to learn that you see, that you worked in a company for several years does not mean you understand how to run a business. There's a business to every passion. There's a business angle to every interest. So for example, if you know how to bake cakes, baking cakes is not cake business. Selling cakes is cake business. So transactions. So what had happened was that because I believe I was passionate and I was helping people who reach out to me, I will help them. I felt that they should be paying me. They should be the ones suggesting, please, can you design something for me? No, I was the one required to design products and services that they can now exchange value for. So what I do now, that I train people who want to make those kind of moves or who are struggling in that area to say, look, I know you are technically good in your field, but you must become technically good in making money. So I do a lot in that regard because I realize it's a huge gap. Yes. Everybody can make the kind of salary that they're making if they have an area of interest that they are good, that is outside what they are doing. And some people don't have to leave their job. I know people that I'm helping that have a job, and by the side, they have created not just a side business, they have created business systems that even though they are not there, they are able to run businesses from their office. And I tell people that you need to learn how to make money. That is one course that I think they need to start teaching people early in life. How to make money doesn't fall on you. Making money does not come because you are doing what you are passionate about. Mm-hmm. Making money comes because you have a product or a service that you are selling that people can pay for.
I like the fact that you made a statement. You said there's always a business aspect to a passion. So if I like to sell clothes or to make clothes, and I don't understand the business aspect of making of cloth making, then there's a high tendency that I will not make any profits. Now, so I from what you're saying, I gather that everybody needs to find out the business aspect of whatever passion or purpose they want to get into. Now, there's another conversation about pressure, seeing the fact that, it's what everybody is doing. And that person who is doing it is working for him. Then I jump into it, and it becomes a struggle for me. So in a case like that, is it that I made a wrong move? Because there are still business, there are still people who get into businesses because other people are doing it, and they tend to succeed. Where would be the disconnecting situation for me who goes into that same business, puts everything in place? I just like copy what the next person did and start doing it, but it's still not working for me. Where did I get it wrong in a case like that?
I think that you can copy processes, procedures, but you can't copy passion. There are certain fields, for example, that the drive required to make it happen. It's not just about opening an office and things like that. So someone sees me and says, well, I like the way the guy is speaking. I want to begin to advise people and all that. But if you're not passionate about helping people, you don't have the tendency to want to listen to people, for example. So any coach, for example, needs to have very strong listening skills. If you don't like listening to people, just like talking all the time, you're not going to be a great coach. So you might have a mismatch with regards to the area of passion. The other area that you might have a mismatch is that you might not have enough knowledge of the business. It's not sufficient to put in place all the offices and staff and not understand what drives. And sometimes you might be in a business that requires other things that drive, other forces that drive. Mm-hmm. There are certain businesses, for example, businesses that are driven by relationships. If you don't have those relationships, nobody is going to buy from you.
True.
Do you get my point?
Yes.
The thing that I ask people to do is that anytime you're struggling, check whether it's an alignment challenge or check whether it's a capacity challenge. If it's an alignment challenge, you might just be wasting your time. That everybody is doing something does not mean you are going to succeed in it. That is a fact of life, because if you're not designed with what is required to drive success in those areas, you will not get those results. The other area is a capacity area. You might have the basics, but there's something that is missing. And if you can get that thing, it might actually help you to get better success.
Interesting. It's glad that we're having this conversation today, because a lot of people are struggling between finding their purpose and, you know, excelling in it and using it as you know, there's nothing sweeter than doing what you love doing and you love doing and you get paid for it. And it's so so exciting and so fulfilling, because that's what you can say. But in a case where it's now like, okay, for every young individual right now, the conversation is, or the vision or the goal is, to be an entrepreneur. Start up your own business so that you can be the boss of yourself. You should you shouldn't want to work for somebody for the rest of your life. So this is this is also a conversation that the people talk about. That is it a must? Must everybody be an entrepreneur? Is it compulsory for everyone to be an entrepreneur? Or can you still work for someone else and be successful and move on with life? You know, because I think the society has put a lot of pressure on young people, letting them feel that if you're not an entrepreneur, then you are not fulfilled in whatever field you are doing. If, as take for example, I'm a TV presenter now, I'm having this conversation. I can have a conversation with somebody and they will tell me, where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? Are you looking at opening a TV station? Are you looking at owning a show? Are you looking at... So the expectation from the society is if you are in a particular field, we want to see you owning the field in the next few years, being the one calling the shots in the next few years. But is this always the case? Is it always necessary? Do you think this is the direct way forward for everyone? Because that's where the society is pushing the youth to.
I think the direct answer is a no. I don't think everybody has the capacity to be entrepreneurial. However, I want people that everybody must own a business. Okay. Now, what I mean by that is that because, you see, while you can succeed in your career, and some people, their success be driven from a career perspective, the fact about it is that they get to a stage, they have to either resign or they have to retire. And statistics shows that when people resign like that, except for some people that have been able to stash enough money aside where the return on investment, you know, is enough. Now, in fact, that's what I mean by owning the business. When I say owning the business, I don't mean that you are the CEO or whatever. Own shares in an organization because one day you are going to resign.
Okay.
So now that doesn't require you being entrepreneurial. It means you being frugal, you being very responsible with your finances because there are days that are coming in the future. You can invest. You have a friend who is entrepreneurial. You have enough mind, presence of mind to say, if you ever need an investment in your organization and you buy 10% in this organization, and the guy becomes the Uber of tomorrow. You are made for many, many years after that.
Yes.
However, not everybody is going to be able to start and run a business. And people need to understand that, you see, this thing about being a boss, all right, is not necessarily, I mean, because some, there are many bosses that are climbing bikes and, I mean, not nothing.
Totally. You understand. You understand.
But they're going to have, you know, suitcases and their CEOs, but their C is not complete. What the key thing is this, that you have to be able to understand yourself. You know, it was, I believe it was it Aristotle also who says, man, know thyself. It's so important that, it was Socrates that said it, man, know thyself. You must know yourself. You must know that this is not me. Don't let me join the crowd. Because you see, the uniqueness of every human being, our fingerprints are different, our iris, everything is different. That's why you can have eye recognition. It means that there's a difference you bring into the world, and that should be the premise of what we call your competitive advantage. But unfortunately, we're not schooled to, you know, discover ourselves. And ideally, from, you know, a university, at least, you should, even secondary school, should be, people should be the guidance counselor. In fact, most guidance counselors need guiding and counseling, unfortunately. Do you get my point?
Wow.
Because what it should be, it should be able to help people to say, based on this inclination, these are possible areas. And even parents, most parents still want, I want a doctor in my house. No, your child is designed for success. So your responsibility is observation, you know, support, so that they can, I mean, years ago, nobody would want their child to be a footballer. But today, if you can see your child at the age of two is playing well, you are the one that will take them to football academy because our orientation has changed.
Yes.
Now, we're talking about comedy football. There are new things we'll begin to talk about now. Things around, you know, social media management, things around data analysis. It's a new field. And so the responsibility of parents, because I'll tell you, I mean, as a career coach, that a lot of people are still victims of their parents' misconception. And so they're running that line. Now, it's never late for anybody to make a transition, but basically getting back to your question is the fact that not everybody can be an entrepreneur. But I advise everybody should find a way to own a business in the future.
I like that. So that has been cleared out because it's been putting a lot of pressure on people because it's like, yo, if you're not an entrepreneur, if you're not the one running the business, if you're not the boss, then you have really not reached the peak of your career, the peak of your passion. But now this brings me to the question that has been in every conversation. How do you find your passion? How do you find your purpose? How do you find it? Is it that it must be something I like to do?
To explore.
Yeah. How do you find it?
So the way you find oil is that you explore.
Okay.
And what exploration, I mean, we have exploration organizations in oil before they now discover the oil. And the idea behind it is that, you know, I mean, again, I mean, we spoke about the creationist, you know, dimension. Mm-hmm. And I mean, this is Nigeria. A lot of people say, oh, people are very religious. There's a dimension of you having experiences where you have a divine direction in that area. But in addition to that, I like to tell people that, look, you have to be able to check the areas. For example, I tell people it's very serious. There's a phase of my life that I wanted to be a rapper, R-A-P-P-E-R, you know, join Ice Prince and the other people and stuff like that. And it was simply because I liked music. I still do like music. And I joined a rap group. I explored. 3 times I forgot my rap on stage. Nobody had to tell me anything. I just resigned from that. I've tried so many things. Now, ideally, what we should do in my I have 2 kids. I watch what they're interested in. I'm allowing them to try businesses, try this. And I'm already seeing the tendencies that my children have. My responsibility is to aid them in that regard. Mm. So the challenge you have is that many of us have never explored our interests, because any successful career will be you must be interested in that area, because interest also drives creativity, and creativity is what brings innovation. So you cannot be a leader if you're not interested in that field. So what I ask people to do is basically begin to explore your interest. Oh, I think I'm interested in being an OAP. Can you take your leave and maybe go for 1 month and volunteer for free with Azubia TV or something like that?
Yeah.
Even if it's just for you to observe, you know, be wiping the floor and observe. Observation is enough for you to tell, I don't like this kind of thing. I thought it was something else.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I'm interested in this. Then you go and do a course. You go to one academy, register. You know, your interest will drive you to your destination. So exploration, I think, we don't have enough time to talk about it this morning, but exploration, there are many areas or many ways that I help people to understand how to explore, you know, because people say, I have a job already. Do I resign to go and explore? No, please never do that. You must have what we call your 9 to 5, then your 5 to 9. In other words, when you close from the work you don't like, resume with the work you like. Start reading, start developing, start checking, start trying your weekends, start testing. And I'm telling you that when you begin to do that, even God begins to help you in that direction. That's what I believe.
Interesting. Wow.
Interesting.
This has been a very, very insightful conversation. And because of time, like you said, we would have to wrap this up in a few minutes. But I would just say this: one of some of the key major points that you made out there regarding the question is explore your interests. Don't be boxed in to try out. Try it out. See what it's like. Are you really interested in this? Do you really want to do this? So a lot of times, young people just jump into what it looks like, without knowing how what looks like became. So, I want to be an OAP. I like the lights. I like the fact that I have attention on TV. But they don't know what it takes to actually the process behind this to make this work. But thank you very much for this conversation time. It's been very, very insightful. We will definitely get to do this again some other time, because this, it never ends. We still always need to talk about things like this so that we can inspire people in the right direction. And I appreciate your time. I hope you have an amazing Monday.
You too.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.